Joining us now this morning, we have Moreno's campaign manager, Lito Banayo. Lito, good morning to you.
Good morning, Karen, and thank you for this opportunity.
All right, let's start with this. These unity talks, supposedly against presidential aspirant Bongbong Marcos, you've spoken against it immediately, even presidential aspirant Isko Moreno. Many may be asking, why are you even close to the idea, given that all the alternative candidates or opposition candidates against Mr. Marcos have spoken about him one way or another? And Aksyon Demokratiko was even the party that actually dug up the estate taxes against the Marcoses.
These are two separate issues, Karen. No? By happenstance, based on the column of an article written by Associate Justice Antonio Carpio about the estate tax. No? And so we thought it was a legitimate issue. We believe it is a legitimate issue because it is more than the numbers, no? Which are being disputed by the tax lawyers. No? More than the numbers, it's a case of entitlement. No? It's a case of a family which thinks that they are above the law. So because this is a question of character. This is a question of moral standards. No? I remember, for instance, that when my grandmother died the bank froze her deposit. They learned that she had died. And then it took us some time. We were able to transfer some of her properties to us, no? To my mother, I mean. So why is there a double standard when it comes to the family of a former strongman, Ferdinand Marcos Sr., as against the ordinary people? And that is the point that we're trying to raise. Now, the question of the unity talks, no? The first place, there are no unity talks yet, no? There are none. There is a clamor from some sectors, some of them even our supporters, who are saying that based on the survey numbers, there should be an initiative for the candidates other than Ferdinand Marcos Jr. to get together and talk about forging a common alliance, perhaps coming up with a common candidate, which they will all support, against Ferdinand Marcos Junior, no? But it is at that level. Now, the reason why Isko Moreno is running for president together with Doc Willy Ong as his vice presidential candidate is precisely because we do not want to get caught up in the fight between two warring factions that have controlled political leadership over so many years. 21 years in the case of the Marcoses and continuing in some of their turf in the Ilocos, no? And follow the Liberal Party or now the Pinks, who stem from the Aquino, Cojuangco Aquino camp, no? So we thought that and we believe that this election should be about what candidates should do for the people, given the parlous circumstances we find ourselves in, an economy that has sunk because of the pandemic, a health crisis, so many crises that are impacting negatively on the lives of people. So we propose solutions, and we back that up with actions that the mayor has done in the short period that he has been mayor of the city of Manila, the nation's capital at that. So ganon, hindi away ng dalawang paksyon ang pinaglalaban namin, kundi pinaglalaban namin ano ang mga problema natin at ano mga solusyon para sa ordinaryong tao.
But then, what many observe with Manila Mayor Isko Moreno is he's become, or he wants to be, Duterte 2.0. So it's not about two families anymore. At the very least, with Mr. Marcos, he's quite clear that he wants continuity, and he speaks the message of his version of unity. And with the Vice President Lenny Robredo, it's change, something different from what exists today. But with Mayor Isko wanting the endorsement of President Duterte, there seems to be a confusion on who he is today.
It's Isko Moreno who's fashioning himself as Duterte 2.0. It's some sectors of the public, including some sectors of the media. The point is, there are good things that President Duterte has done. There are things that we do not agree with. So where we agree with, say, kaya, no? Where we do not agree with, as in human rights records, for instance, even in the last debate about Senator Laila De Lima, we took a very strong stand that she should be given accorded due process, no? And her rights should be respected, no? So, kung saan sa tingin namin, tama naman si Pangulo Duterte, bakit naman namin lalabanan? Kung saan naman tingin namin hindi maganda, no? Then we speak out naturally. So, yung 2.0, Duterte 2.0, is more siguro akin to Ferdinand Marcos Jr., who from the very start has said, everything that President Duterte has done is correct and he is going to continue this. No? And in fact, he even appropriated for himself the president's daughter as his vice presidential candidate. No? So siya yung Duterte 2.0. No? Not that, we're taking a middle stand on this. No? Hindi pwedeng galit kami dito. In fact, one of the reasons why during the so-called unity talks that Vice President Lenny Robredo tried to foster or initiated in the middle of early months and middle of 2021, one of the key factors that she kept saying, and even some of her, some of the leaders of the Liberal Party, at that time she was still, she's still chairperson of the Liberal Party, and was that vague daw, she wanted Isko Moreno to take a strong stand against Marcos, which we did not think was proper because it's not about, we keep repeating, it's not about Marcos versus liberals, Marcos versus the Apinos. It's not about that. It's about the lives of people. No? It's about how we can improve their lives given the pandemic circumstances and now the externalities that are impacting negatively on our lives.
Okay, now let's get on to the truth, based at least on the surveys that have come out, is if the opposition or the alternative candidates don't unite in some way, you do have Mr. Marcos, who all the alternative candidates, all the other candidates are criticizing and are attacking, will win as president of the Philippines. Based on the surveys, ito, sir. So at the end of the day, without unity from the other candidates, ang panalo yung taong tinitira ng lahat ng kandidato. The irony is Mr. Marcos didn't step into the race without unity with Sara Duterte. At the very least, he had that wisdom. I have to hand it to them. Mr. Marcos and Sara Duterte made sure that they were together. You know, he entered the race cautiously. You know, he did not want to lose again. He did not want his 2016 experience to be repeated. But let's face it, if there is no unity with any of the four, the chances of him winning will be greater than ever. So what is the point of all this, sir?
Well, unang-una, Karen, ano?
Oo.
Yung bang surveys right now, no, are true pictures of the public sentiment, no, because of the fake the disinformation, fake news, paid trolls and all that, maraming ayaw magsalita ng kanilang ayaw magbigay ng true sentiments nila about their choices. Precisely because binabash sila, no? Marami, for instance, celebrities, no? Na ayaw lang makisaw-saw sa politika even if they favor this or that candidate precisely because of the bashing, which of course would impact on their livelihood. Maraming ganyan, no? While I do not, I'm not saying that these are fake surveys, whichever they are, no? The point is, no, we cannot allow our electoral choices to be dictated by surveys. Otherwise, huwag na tayo mag-eleksyon, mag-surveys na lang. Number one. Number two, paano kung matauhan ang tao between now and May 9? Matauhan ang tao na yung mga sinasabi na unity at kung ano-ano pang mga sinasabi ni presidential candidate Ferdinand Marcos Jr. ay hindi pala totoo, naloko pala sila, nagoyo pala sila, then their votes migrate to somebody else. Now, who will it migrate to? Will it migrate to Lenny Robredo? Will it migrate to Isko Moreno? Will it migrate to Ping Lacson or to Manny Pacquiao? We do not know that at this point in time. No? We do not even know at this point in time what traction the 203 billion estate tax issue has had on the chances or on the numbers, rather, of Mr. Marcos Jr. No? So, parang hindi nababagay na pag-usapan yung unity, no? Samantalang from the very beginning, gaya nga ng laging nasasabi namin, yung pag-uusap tungkol dyan ay dapat closed with sincerity, no? And seriousness, no? Hindi yung basta na lamang, you know, kung talagang gusto ng unity, di ba, madali naman mag-pick up ng telepono at kausapin yung kandidato. Di ba? Eh bakit dadaanin sa mga media releases nitong ganito, nitong ganon, isang tao sa Cebu magsasalita? You know, things like those, no? So you do not promote unity that way, no?
So, kumbaga, Alito, what you're saying in the first place is all of these supposed unity talks are insincere to begin with. It doesn't exist. It's not real.
Walang nangyayaring unity talks. No? Even the spokesperson of Vice President Robredo yesterday in another program over station.
I watched you.
They're not initiating any talks, no? Kung, di ba? Yung ganun eh. When Senator Ping Lacson withdrew or resigned from the Partido Reforma, we were all shocked, no? When that happened. Although not in my case, because Speaker Bebot Alvarez called me up the afternoon before, informed me about their decision, no? So I knew beforehand, no? And then I thought that hindi maganda yung ginawa nila kay Senator Lacson, but that is politics, no? Wala tayong magagawa doon.
Mm-mm. All right. Well, I think last words, just very quickly, Lito, because I don't have enough time. Is there any? Yes, we still have a month to go, but is there any time bound period that Isko is giving himself? We know what happened in 2016, when Mar or Grace would not give in. It even solidified Duterte's victory even more. And right now in the surveys, you do have Lenny and Isko right there, who may come out to either 2 or 3 or 3 or 2. It doesn't, you know. Are you seeing a possibility of correcting 2016?
Well, no, we're staying the course, Karen. I'm sorry to have to say this because I know that a lot of people are speculating about the possibility of, you know, someone withdrawing in favor of somebody else. We are staying the course. gaya nga na sinasabi ni Isko na isasanla ang laway niya, nailabas na niya yung laway niya na siya'y tatakbo dahil gusto niya ipaglaban ang karapatan ng mga tao para sa isang disente at maayos na pamumuhay. So he's staying the course till the end.
Yeah. On that note, well, Lito, I know we'll be speaking again with each other. There's just so much to talk about politics. Thank you so much for joining me, and you take care and good luck with the campaign.
Salamat, Karen. Maraming salamat.